إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and peace and blessings upon the Messenger of Allah. And I bear witness that there is no deity other than Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and messenger. My brothers and sisters, know that the person travels to Allah through his heart and his determination and not with his body. And taqwa in reality is the taqwa of the heart. And the deeds of the heart are more mandatory than the deeds of the limbs. And the servitude of the heart is greater than the servitude of the limbs. And from among the greatest worship of the heart is worship of Ar-Raja. Ar-Raja means hope. Ar-Raja, hope, is hoping for the grace and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and anticipating his bounty and favor, and faith and satisfaction in his bestowal and generosity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna alladhina amanu walladhina hajaru wajahadu fi sabilillah أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. Indeed, those who have believed and those who have emigrated and fought in the cause of Allah Ta'ala, in cause of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, those expect the mercy of Allah, and Allah is forgiving and merciful. My brothers and sisters, Ahmad ibn Asim was asked, what is the sign of a person that he having Raja, hope? He replied, if he is covered by grace, to be inspired, to be grateful, longing for the complete favor from Allah upon him in this world and in the hereafter. And from this, we know the difference between the fruitful Raja, hope, and wishing and delusion. With wishing comes laziness and abandoning deeds and not taking the path of seriousness and carefulness. My brothers, as for the Raja, hope, it comes with deeds and acts. and extending effort and correct alliance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. So whoever would hope for the meeting with his Lord, let him do righteous work and not associate in the worship of his Lord anyone. My brothers, as for the delusion, it is having false hope with deficiency in taking the required means while doing deeds to the contrary. Yahya ibn Muaz said, I define delusion as persisting in sin while hoping for pardoning without feeling regret and expecting closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without performing acts of obedience. A famous poet, Abu Latahiya, said in one couplet, Tarjun najata walam tasluk masalikaha. Tarjun najata walam tasluk masalikaha. Inna safinata la tajri ala al-yabasi. Meaning, you wish for salvation and have not taken its path. You wish for salvation and have not taken its path. Indeed, the ship does not run on land. My brothers, it is sufficient for hope, Raja, as a station that it is the servitude of prophets. Ibrahim alayhi salam, Abu Lambiya, he said, Wallazi nafsi, wallazi atmau, an yaghfira li khati'ati yawmaddin. Wallazi atmau, an yaghfira li khati'ati yawmaddin. And who I aspire that he will forgive me my sin on the day of recompense, resurrection. And it is one of the characteristics of scholars who are the knowledgeable of Allah Almighty, who knows Allah Almighty with his names. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about them, Amman huwa qanitun ana al-layli sajidan wa qa'ima يحذر الآخرة ويرجو رحمة ربه قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب. Meaning, is one who is devoutly obedient during periods of the night, prostrating and standing in prayer, fearing the hereafter and hoping for the mercy of his Lord, like one who does not. Say, are those who know equal to those who do not know? Only they will remember who are people of understanding. And those who hoping for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those performing acts of obedience. The ones who perform what Allah has commanded and refrain from what Allah has prohibited. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُورَ. Indeed, those who recite the book of Allah and establish prayer and spend in his cause out of what we have provided them, secretly and publicly, can expect a transaction that will never perish. My dear brothers and sisters, hope, ar-raja, is a great worship of heart that has an effect on the iman of a Muslim and his behavior. From its effects on iman, faith is displaying servitude and the need for what he hopes for from his Lord. And he looks forward to his generosity, his forgiveness. And he, at the same time, fears from his punishment. And he does not dispense from his grace and generosity even for a glimpse of an eye. Also, my brothers, hope, raja, places the person on the doorstep of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For as his hope, raja, increases and he obtains what he hopes for, he increases in love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Gratitude to Allah, being pleased with Allah, and Allah being pleased with him. My brothers, moreover, hope or raja raise him to the highest level, which is the level of gratitude, which is the essence of servitude to Allah. For if he obtains what he hoped for, he is more likely to have gratitude. And from the fruits, my brothers and sisters, of hope and raja is that it needs increasing in knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his names, their meanings, and attachment to them. For indeed, in practicing hope or raja is attachment to his beautiful names, worshipping and supplicating through them, and leaving all else. Allah said in the Holy Quran, أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة أيهم أقرب ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه إن عذاب ربك كان محذورا. Those whom they invoke seek means of access to their Lord, striving as to which of them would be nearest, and they hope for his mercy and fear his punishment. Indeed, the punishment of your Lord is ever feared. My brothers and sisters, from the effects of hope, raja, and behavior is that those practicing hope are the closest in following the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. There has certainly been for you in the Messenger of Allah an excellent pattern for anyone whose hope is in Allah and the last day and who remembers Allah after. And my brothers, also whoever hopes in Allah, he thinks well of Allah. He always positive with Allah. And thinking well of Allah raises the level of person with his Lord, his attachment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu related that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, يَقُولُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى حَدِيثُ قُدْسِ. Allah says, أَنَا عِنْدَ زَنَّ عَبْدِي بِي. This hadith, muttafaqun alayhi hadith. Allah says, I am to my slave as he thinks of me. Meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am able to do for him what he thinks I can do for him. My dear brothers and sisters, and from its effects is that hope, raja, drives a person to repent and return to Allah. And repentance is among the most beloved deed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you raise your hands and ask forgiveness from Allah to Allah, Allah become happy to you. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لو يعلم المؤمن ما عند الله من العقوبة ما تمي بجنته أحد ولو يعلم الكافر ما عند الله من الرحمة ما خنت من جنته أحد. If the believer knew that what is with Allah of punishment, none would hope for paradise. And if the disbeliever knew what is with Allah of mercy, none would despair of attaining paradise. This hadith is reported by Imam Muslim. There is nothing between the sinner and the mercy of his Lord except that he leaves the sin and feels regret over it and is determined that he will not return to it and that he asks for Allah's forgiveness. By doing so, Allah's words apply to him. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا أَوْ يَظْلِمْ نَفْسَهُ ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهَ يَجِدِ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And whoever does it wrong or wrongs himself but then seeks forgiveness of Allah will find Allah forgiving and merciful. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدْنِي المؤمن فيضع عليه كنفه ويستره فيقول أتعرف ذنب كذا أتعرف ذنب كذا فيقول نعم أي ربي حتى إذا قرره بذنوبه ورآه في نفسه أنه هلك قال سترتها عليك في الدنيا ولأغفرها لك اليوم. الله أكبر. The believer will be brought to close his Lord until he will cover him with his screen and ask him, did you commit such and such sins? He will say, yes. Yes, my Lord. Allah will keep on asking him till he will confess all his sins and will think that he is ruined. Allah will say that time, I conceal your sins in this world, in dunya, and I forgive them for you today. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وأصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. My dear brothers and sisters, hope, raja is not without fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For they are like two wings of a bird. If they are balanced, the bird is able to fly. But if one of them is deficient, then the bird is impaired. And if they disappear, the bird is on the blink of death and falls. And there are many verses in the book of Allah Almighty in which he combined fear and hope, and between mercy and punishment, which causes a person to be between fear and hope. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِن كَذَّبُكَ فَخُلْ رَبُّكُمْ ذُو رَحْمَهُ ذو رحمة واسعة ولا يرد بأسه عن القوم المجرمين. So if they deny you, O Muhammad, say your Lord is the possessor of vast mercy, but his punishment cannot be repelled from the people who are criminals. And Allah said, نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. O Muhammad, inform my servants that it is I who am the forgiving, the merciful, and that is my punishment, which is the painful punishment. And Allah further said, قَالَ عَذَابِ أُصِيبُ بِهِ مَنْ أَشَاءُ وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِيَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. Allah says, My punishment I afflict with it whom I will. My punishment I afflict with it whom I will, but my mercy encompasses all things. And Allah said, Inna rabbaka sari'ul iqab wa innahu laghafur rahim. Indeed, your Lord is swift in penalty, but indeed He is forgiving and merciful. And Allah says, غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. The forgiver of sin, acceptor of repentance, severe in punishment, owner of abundance. There is no deity except Him. To Him is the destination. And Allah says, وَدْعُوهُ خَوْفًا وَتَمَعًا, and invoke Him in fear and aspiration. So, let our hope and thinking well towards Allah Almighty be more than our dependence and our deeds and acts of obedience. For Allah's mercy and generosity is more than we think. Rather, it is beyond our perceptions. So think well towards your Lord and hopeful. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Almighty, to make us among those who balance hope and fear of our Lord. Indeed, Allah is all hearing, answering. هذا وصلوا وسلموا على نبيكم كما أمركم بذلك ربكم فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وصلي على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى الملائكة المقربين وعلى الخلفاء الراشدين وعلى الصحابة كلهم أجمعين وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولوالدي والدينا ولأساتذتنا وجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم وجعلنا منهم واخذل من قذل دين محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم عباد الله أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله رحمني ورحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأجل وأتم وأهم وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون قيموا الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
سوء التدل الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها، لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت، ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا، ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا، ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به، واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا، أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. الله